still on the bus.
It's been a week already today, right?
How many of you guys believe that we were just driving just to drive?
Think about these words I'm about to say. Ask for the strength, the ability, the attitude, and the action to be a bond servant for Jesus this week.
Everybody stand up and put your hands up.
I once was fatherless, a stranger with no hope.
Second half of Jesus is here. You ready to have some fun?
You have an awesome responsibility set before you. God has placed you here to be used as instruments and tools of His hand to spread His amazing story. What you do, what you pour into somebody else's life, will last forever. The biggest thing you can do is share your faith, share your story with somebody else, and impact their life forever.
Who wants to be a safety inspector? The one who can.
Okay, I've got four positions that we need to fill.
You're gonna be brake master. Okay, what that is?
Make it all better when I'm feeling sad. Tell me that I'm special even when I know.
Three,
I'm
one, two, three.
Bone crushers!
All right.
Now I feel good when I hurt so bad. Barely getting mad. I'm so glad I found you. I love being around.
What are you all doing today, do you know?
I'm doing sheetrock. Whatever that is.
Easy as one, two, one. There's only one thing to do. Three words for you. There's only one thing to do, three words for you. I love you. There's only one way to say those three words. That's what I'll do. I love you.
It's a joke.
I love you.
Pray for the work on this house, Father. You just continue to. To a wonder here, a beautiful work of art.
Helped put up walls, and then we cut out the sheetrock the way we want it, and then we go and put it up there, and then we put the inner screw.
Okay.
Then we hope we don't get hurt.
Cool how you could do a really small thing and it would make a really big impact on someone. And I think that giving someone a new house is like a way of giving someone a new beginning, and it gives them a way to start over.
Well, Hannah and I did a lot of sheetrocking today. We talked to the owners a lot, and their house was destroyed by Hurricane Ike. And so we fixed it up, and I think that'll make a really big impact on them, because they'll know that like junior high students from a church in Houston went there to help them.
We really got to show Christ, because like when the owner came, he was just like amazed that we're like giving up our spring break to help him out.
We got to paint a house and rebuild a fence for people who had been hurt in some of the past hurricanes. And it was really awesome.
Love is here. Love is now.
It's neat to see the kids get totally involved and be really excited about serving. And they're all just like so ready to help in any way that they can.
I put the sheetrock on the walls of the community center. We got a lot finished. It's pretty cool.
today we met a guy named Joe, and he said that he goes to church and stuff, but he said he was going to bring his friends back tomorrow. And so I think that was a big impact, because now we're probably going to teach a lot of people about the gospel tomorrow.
It was just really cool to see what God did today.
I am so happy. It's just a life-changing experience.
We will absolutely be doing this again, because it's always fun to spend time just hanging out with one another. And I think it's just important that we get away and we focus on helping others.
If you didn't come, it's not good, because you could have deepened your walk with God a lot more than you probably have ever in your life.
All of a sudden, Josh walked in here and said, I need to accept Christ.
My defining moment was today, Friday, 6 p.m. My life totally changed, and God consumed me.
From his brow, love is here.